Hello friends, welcome to Electrical Bytes. And in this video we are going to discuss some of the important MCQs on networks and fields. So let us start. So the first question is, Gauss theorem is also called as curl theorem, divergence theorem, Helmholtz theorem, none. So the correct option is divergence theorem. Gauss theorem is also called as divergence theorem. Next is Ampere circuit law is also called as Ampere energy law, Ampere power law, Ampere work law or none. So the correct option is Ampere work law. Ampere circuit law is also called as Ampere work law. Next is, if V is the electrical potential, then Laplace equation is defined as. So the options are divergence of V is equal to 0, divergence square of V is equal to 0, curl of E is equal to 0 or none. So the correct option is the Laplace equation is defined as divergence square of V is equal to 0. So the second option is correct. Next is, if V is the electrical potential, then Poisson's equation is defined as. The options are divergence of V is equal to 0, divergence square of V is equal to rho by epsilon naught, and curl of V is equal to 0 or none. So the correct option is the Poisson's equation is defined as curl of V is equal to 0. Next is, which one of the following is the basic law of magnetic fields? So the options are Lenz's law, Faraday's law, Gauss law or Ampere circuit law. So the correct option is Ampere circuit law. Ampere circuit law is the basic law of magnetic fields. Next is Biot-Savart's law is sometimes referred as Laplace law, induction law, flux law or none. So the correct option is Laplace law. Biot-Savart's law is sometimes referred as Laplace law. Next is Poynting theorem is defined as the rate of flow of energy P is the vector product of. So the options are P is equal to E curl of E and B. Next is P is equal to curl of E and H. Next is P is dot product of E and H, or fourth option, none. So the correct option is Poynting theorem is defined as P is equal to curl of E and H. Here E is the electrical field and H is the magnetic field. So it is the curl vector product of E and H. Next is Fleming's right hand rule is also called as motor rule, generator rule, machine rule or none. So the correct option is generator rule. Fleming's right hand rule is called as generator rule. Next is Fleming's left hand rule is also called as machine rule, generator rule, motor rule or none. So the correct option is motor rule. Fleming's left hand rule is also called as motor rule. Next is the hysteresis and eddy current losses of a magnetic material are dissipated in the form of heat, noise, arc or none. So the hysteresis and eddy current loss are dissipated in the form of heat. Next is the time constant for a RL circuit is the time taken by dash to reach dash percent. So the options are voltage to 63%, current to 63%, voltage to 37%, current to 37%. So the time constant for a RL circuit is the time taken by the current to reach 63% of its final value. Next is the time constant for a RC circuit is the time taken by dash to reach dash percent. So the options are voltage to 63%, current 63%, voltage 37% and current 37%. So the time constant for a RC circuit is the time taken by the voltage to reach 63% of its final value. So for RL circuit it is current to reach 63% and for RC circuit it is voltage to reach 63%. Next is the resistance when the wire is touched to n times of its original value is R dash, then its original resistance R is. The options are R dash by n square, R dash into n square, R into n or R by n. So the correct option is R dash to R dash by N square. So the original resistance is R dash by N square. Next is, which theorem is applicable for linear or non-linear circuits? So the options are Thevenin, Norton, Millimans or Telligence. So the correct option is Telligence. Telligence theorem is applicable for both linear or non-linear circuits. Next is, which theorem is applicable for both active and passive circuits? The options are Thevenin, Norton, Millimans or Telligence. The correct option is Telligence. Telligence theorem is applicable for both active and passive circuits. Next is, the theorem which gives an equivalent voltage or current source is Millimans theorem, Norton theorem, Thevenin or Telligence. So the correct theorem which gives the equivalent voltage or current source is Millimans theorem. Next is, equivalent resistance between any two terminals of a delta connected resistance network. So the options are 1 by 3 into R, 2 by 3 into R, 3 by 2 into R or 1 by 1/4 of R. So the equivalent resistance between any two terminal of a delta connected resistance network is 2 by 3 into R. Next is, equivalent capacitance between any two terminals of a delta connected capacitor network. Options are 1/3, 2/3, 3 by 2 or 1/4. So the correct option is 3 by 2. So the equivalent capacitance between any two terminals of a delta connected capacitor network is 3 by 2 of its each capacitance. Next is, in a frequency versus impedance characteristics of a series RLC circuit, the inductive reactance represents. So as you can see over here they have given the impedance versus frequency characteristics of a series RLC circuit. So they are asking the inductive reactance. So the inductive reactance is a straight linear curve, linear straight line. As you can see over here, this is the reactance and this is the capacitive reactance. This is inductive reactance and this is capacitive reactance. So the inductive reactance is a linear straight line. Next is, in a frequency versus admittance characteristics shown below of a parallel RLC circuit, the capacitive susceptance represents dash. So here they are given the admittance versus frequency characteristics of a parallel RLC circuit. Here the RLC circuit is nothing but parallel, all the three elements are connected in parallel. So here the capacitive susceptance is a straight linear curve, as you can see over here. So it's a straight linear curve. This is the capacitive susceptance and this curve is the inductive susceptance. So the capacitive susceptance is a linear straight curve. So the option one is correct. So these are some of the important MCQs of networks and fields. So I thank you for watching. So I hope this video was useful for you. So, and if you really find this content to be useful, so please do like, share and comment, and don't forget to subscribe our channel, that is Electrical Bytes, for more videos. Thank you.